Go ahead and get into the word, and hopefully we can do a little bit of deliverance today. Y'all be praying, because that is something that the enemy fights. This is the time of the year when you might be walking around as a Christian and feel like all your enemy is drained, all of your energy is drained. For those that have been around a while, we know that this is sometimes it can be spiritual warfare. Other times it could be, many things. It could be poor diet. It could be anything. But as spiritual beings, we try to stay attuned to the spirit realm, because that is where we need to tap into in a true way through the Word of God. Because when we became born again, we became something that exists now that did not exist before. And I said that last week. I said that we are new creatures. I also mentioned that we have external things that have affected us internally, even from a child, even as we grew up in this life. And this is before we became born again. These things affected us and were sometimes carried over into our Christianity. Now, I personally believe that God can fully deliver somebody right off the bat. I do. But I believe there are laws in the spirit realm that we cannot ignore. And I just want to read a couple of scriptures about the new man. And when I use that word man, I use it because in the King James Version of the Bible, it refers to that, but it does not. It also says in Galatians, there's neither male nor female, Jew nor Gentile. We're all one in Christ Jesus. So it's not really, I'm not referring to gender. Okay? Because our spirit man, the Bible says we're married now, for instance, but we won't be married in heaven, me and my wife, because it says you're neither married or given in marriage. It's going to be a whole lot different than what we ever could imagine, amen, could ever dream of. I don't know if you ever think about heaven. I do. I think about being heaven bound, and we're also heaven sent in accordance with the Great Commission. But Ephesians chapter 4:24 says, and that ye put on the new man, which after God is created in righteousness and true holiness. And that's done through the Word of God. That's done through really seeking the Lord and digging in his word. I mean, hey, we only have so many hours in a day. I get it. Many of us work really hard and we come into tiredness and all types of things, but we can at least have the Bible in our car playing when we're driving around, or we can have it in our house playing, you know, just playing over you. Because the Word of God is really what transforms us. It's not I'm not calling church a ritual. I'm not calling prayer a ritual. But it's our relationship with God is what causes us to be transformed. It's our relationship, especially after we become Christians. Before my Christianity, before I met God, I felt like God was there, but I could not reach him. I had a fear of God, and I knew there was a God, but I did not know him. And it's a pity and a shame to be a Christian. And I call a Christian anybody that has, the Bible says, if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God hath raised him from the dead, you shall be saved. That's what the Bible says. It says, confess with your mouth. Yes, Lord, I believe that you died, were buried, and you were resurrected from the grave. But then after that, something happens inside of us. It happened right then when we said, yes, Jesus, I receive you. We received what the Bible talks about, white linen, in Revelations 19:7-8. It says, let us be glad and rejoice and give honor to him, for the marriage of the Lamb is come, and his wife hath made herself ready. Verse 8, and to her was granted that she should be arrayed in fine linen, clean and white, for the fine linen is the righteousness of the saints. So I would like to, and I believe that if God was to open our eyes, our spiritual eyes, we would see white linen on us. We would see clean and white linen that doesn't need ironing. It doesn't need to be put in the washing machine with Downy and all your good stuff that you put in there, because it's never going to get dirty. Because the Bible says he's coming for a bride without spot or wrinkle. Hey, sometimes we feel like we have wrinkles and we have spots. I can only speak for myself. But I can tell you, that is why we have repentance. That's why we have grace and mercy in our lives. The enemy wants to put us in condemnation all the time. He would even use other people's mouths sometimes to put condemnation on you. Y'all heard of the term using clay lips. We all got those clay lips. Clay is dirt. And we were dirt until Jesus breathed life into us. Amen. But we have to know that we should keep our vessels guarded as Christians. Keep our vessels guarded. Because there's so many entrances through sin that can come into our lives. When we were kids, for instance, we couldn't help sometimes what a grown-up may have done to us. We couldn't help sometimes what a grown-up may have said to us or done to us. But I call them trespassers. I call them invaders. And those trespassers and invaders entered when some of those activities happened. If y'all know what I'm talking about spirits. I call them trespassers because before we became born again, they were not necessarily trespassers as much as when you become a Christian. And a trespasser in the physical realm is a person entering someone's land or property without permission. They feel they don't need permission because they will enter. And in the spirit realm, it's the same way, because the Bible says that we are a house or a tabernacle. Y'all know that scripture in Matthew chapter 12, verse 43 through 45 says, when the unclean spirit is gone out of a man, he walketh through the dry places seeking rest and findeth none. The only way I know of an unclean spirit going out of a person is if they're kicked out. That's what the ministry of deliverance is about. It is about kicking them out. But only the house that they dwell in, that person that has that house, must be in agreement with that. We shouldn't kick spirits out of a house that the person is not willing to walk circumspectly or upright. Hey, they may not know how they're going to do it at first, but God will show them through his word. I remember when I first became a Christian and God opened my spiritual eyes, nobody had to tell me to read my Bible. Nobody had to coerce me to read my Bible or tell me continuously to read my Bible. But that scripture says, he walketh through dry places seeking rest and findeth none. When the spirit is outside of the body, it needs a body to act through. That's what it desires. That's why the Gadarene that was possessed with a legion of spirits, the spirits inside of that man said, allow us to go into the pigs. Matthew 12, verse 44. Then he said, I will return into my house. They want to return to the house. That's why deliverance is not anything to really bat an eye at or play with. Because they seek to return. And some of them that try to return are very wicked spirits. They are spirits that have been around for generations. And when the name of Jesus is invoked and they come out, they don't want to come out. They want to stay. He said, I will return to my house from which I came out. And when he has come, he find it empty, swept, and garnished. You might look at that and say, that's good. If the house is empty, swept, and garnished. But I don't know about you. You walk in a house that's empty, nothing in it, but it's swept and clean. That's a good thing. But where are you going to sleep? On the floor? The point is, when a person receives deliverance, they feel empty. They feel clean. But the point in verse, we're supposed to be filled with the things of God. That's what it means. When those spirits come out, we don't just go about our own business, go about what we did before, do the things we did before. We must be mindful that a spiritual thing has happened to us. The Bible says that the finger of God has come upon you when you receive deliverance. It is a mighty thing. Verse 45. So I'm going to go back to 44. It says, find it empty, swept, and garnished. So like I said, fill yourself with the word, some of the word. Read a scripture a day. If you can't read nothing, listen to the Bible. Find a something that fits into your schedule. Find something. Pull yourself away to find something. Because what happened is, we know that things in this life don't show right away. When a person, I'm just going to use food for example. Okay? Don't nobody get offended, please. We don't know. We don't show. For instance, I know sometimes because of my job, I neglect to eat because I get busy on my job. But when I was my right weight that I was supposed to be, and I started neglecting to eat, it doesn't show right away. But give it about 6 months or 3 months, then it will all of a sudden start showing. The same thing with eating too much or eating the wrong things. It doesn't show right away. It shows in the by and by. It may not affect our health. The things that we do may not affect our spiritual health right away. Sin may not affect your spiritual health right away, especially if you can catch it and you can repent of it. But as we continue to do things, that's when it will start to affect. We may find ourselves growing cold on the Lord. We might find ourselves not as enthusiastic about reading the Word of God or about praying. I get it. It's a very difficult life. Life is not easy. It's not easy. And we're only human beings. We're not super saints. Only Jesus is the super one. He's the Superman. Amen. That's what the song said. Jesus is the super. Is that what they said? The Superman? Or they said something. Ron Canole said that song. Super something. But the tragedy is, and the danger is in verse 45. It says, then goeth he and taketh with himself seven other spirits more wicked than himself, and they enter in and dwell there. And the last state of that man is worse than the first. Even so shall it be unto this wicked generation. And that means if a spirit goes out, it goes out and it goes to the dry places seeking rest, findeth none. It gets seven of its buddies, and eight spirits come back to dwell and to look and dwell there. So each individual spirit. So look at, if you use legion for an example, the Bible says a legion is from 2,000 to 6,000 spirits. So you do the math. It's exponential. Amen. So the ministry of deliverance, I know after receiving deliverance, it is such a glorious feeling and you feel great. But there is a different walk that a person that has received deliverance walks than a what we sometimes call a carnal Christian. Amen. And we always try to get people that we minister to over time to get out of the thing of how big the devil is, how powerful the devil is. We must understand that Jesus Christ is bigger than the devil. We've got to have a big Jesus and a small devil. I can tell you when I first got deliverance, I was aware, and it took me some time to bind spirits in the dark. It took me some time to just be able to bind and to believe in my spirit that something's happening. I know what it feels like to give up. I know what it feels like to pray and it seems like nothing's happening. That is what, when we pray in English or our native language, sometimes that feeling of hopelessness will come. That's why Paul said in Corinthians, he said, "For if I pray in an unknown tongue, my spirit prayeth, but my understanding is unfruitful. Howbeit in the spirit I speak mysteries." Then he turned around and said, "It edifies me." That means it strengthens me. So the prayer in the Holy Ghost, I've always, y'all heard me say it so many times, is the most powerful prayer that any Christian can do. Amen. I've heard false tongues too. Because the enemy tries to imitate anything that the devil, that Jesus does. So what I'm trying to drop a little nugget in your spirit. If you don't have your prayer language, seek God, get into the word, and you won't even need a minister around for you to receive the Holy Ghost. Amen. I'm saying that for the people sitting here, and as always, I'm saying it for the people listening to this tape. The prayer in the Holy Ghost is, the Bible says, he takes those prayers to the throne of, he being the Holy Spirit, takes those prayers to the throne of God with groanings that cannot be uttered. So when you're praying in the Holy Ghost, you might be doing some supernatural warfare that you don't even know is going on at the time. But sometimes God will just open your spiritual eyes suddenly and let you see it for just a little bit and take and close it back. It's not that we pray in the Holy Spirit so we can see things in the spirit. That's not what the Paul said it's for. Paul said it's to edify us. It's to give us strength when we feel weak. We love Jesus, yes, our hearts, we love Jesus with all of our hearts. But sometimes as we go along this, as pilgrims going along this road, trying to, walking on that straight and narrow, you get weary. You get physically tired, mentally tired, and spiritually tired. The Bible says, be not weary in well-doing. But Paul told Timothy to fight the good fight of what? Faith. Faith is built around the word of God. It's not built around ritualism. You can't go to Walmart and buy faith. Amen. We can't go to the doctor, make a doctor's appointment and get faith. We can't do anything on this earth to get faith. Nothing. But through this word that he left. And Jesus said, it's good for you that I go away, because I'm going to send the Comforter, who is the Holy Ghost, who will lead you into all truth. Don't worship the Holy Ghost, though, because he said, Jesus said, he will not speak of himself. Jesus said, but whatsoever he hears, that is what he will speak. The Holy Ghost didn't die for us. Jesus did. Luke 10:19, he said, behold, I give unto you power to tread on serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. We've been talking about the spirit of fear. We've been talking about this fear, how we can walk around daily in a fear state, because that spirit of fear is one of the main spirits that operates. But also what operates is sometimes it gives that spirit of fear power is when we have unforgiveness in our hearts and our minds. Unforgiveness is one of the main spirits that works with what we've been talking about. And that is the spirit of rebellion, rejection, and spirit of fear. Unforgiveness is a breeding ground for spirits. It's a breeding ground. That's why the Bible said in Matthew chapter 6, verse 14 and 15, for if you don't forgive men their trespasses, your heavenly Father verse 14, for if you forgive men their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you forgive not men their trespasses, neither will your Father forgive you your trespasses. For some people it's easier to forgive than for others. I don't know, somehow God gave me a gift. I feel God gave me a gift to be able to forgive. Even before I was a Christian, I found it easy to forgive. Yes, there are some things, don't get me wrong, there are some things that tried that gift. And that's why when you pray in your unknown tongue, when you pray in the spirit, your spirit man is like in a ready state to be able to combat things in the spirit realm. If your spirit man is weak and feeble, it's hard to combat things that are going on in the spirit realm. It's spirit to spirit. Your flesh can do nothing. I can be the heavyweight champion of the world, but I can't fight a demon with my bare hands. Huh? Then it talks about in Matthew 18, when that unforgiveness is there, it says the tormentors will come. Unforgiveness brings tormentors. Look at that parable. Read it when you get home in Matthew chapter 18. It'll bring the tormentors. And it opens the gate for a flood of spirits. Like I said, I'm not advocating for anybody to put the devil in a place where Jesus goes. Jesus is King of Kings and Lord of Lords. However, we must know him, lest he gets advantage of us. I want to go into what I was teaching about last week. I started teaching about it, and I started telling you about trauma. I said all that that I just said just to remind you, because we, in order for us to do, I want to give you a heads up and remind you for when we do deliverance, for those that want to receive deliverance. Keep in mind, you don't have to receive, you don't have to participate ever, especially in group deliverance. That's why we ask people if they want to be free before we pray deliverance over them. Because it's by an act of your will. Deliverance is not supposed to be forced on anybody. But I want to talk about trauma. And bear with me here, because I'm going to just give you a little simple lesson on what trauma, what I'm studying, what trauma is. And there is a term called PTSD. Anybody ever heard of that? Post-traumatic stress syndrome. That word post means after. So after trauma. And a simple definition for trauma would be a disturbing, shocking memory that is replayed over and over in a person's mind at any given time. So it is a disturbing event that happened. A trauma is something disturbing that has happened. After your experience of trauma, there's a syndrome, and that word means symptom. We've heard of PTSD concerning soldiers that have been over into combat, and some of those people have extreme PTSD or extreme trauma where they experience flashback memories, and it's an extreme form where they are almost like in a waking nightmare. Trauma opens a person to the powers of the spirit of fear. Examples of other spirits that follow are fear, rejection, self-hatred, self-rejection, bitterness, abandonment, insanity, unloving spirits, and competitions. You might ask from some examples of trauma or events that involve trauma. Some of them are being involved in a motor vehicle accident, minor or major. Anybody ever heard? Have been in a motor vehicle accident, minor or major, fender bender. If your mother, you were in your mother's womb and she didn't want you, in other words, an unwanted pregnancy, conceived through rape, conceived out of wedlock, rejection because of wrong gender, abandonment, means given up for adoption, which brings the curse of the bastard. Being in child care, growing up without a parent, like in a divorce or separation. If you had to move a lot, I know that affects some kids a lot. When they establish friends, then all of a sudden they have to move. Extreme physical and verbal abuse. Anybody ever had that? You had brothers and or sisters and felt that they were loved more than you. Did your parents ever go through a divorce or you had a divorce? Did you grow up in a false religion? Or you made a decision to join a false religion? Have you experienced cult abuse or ritual abuse? And I'm going to tell you the result of this, that spirits may operate in your life as a result of those things. And as a result of those traumas, you experience self-blame, self-consciousness, shame or guilt, chronic or excessive anger or sadness, indecisiveness, confusion, and hard to think, worry, anxiety, obsessive thinking, unpleasant feelings, mood swings, negativity, pessimism, irritability. I know I felt some of those things. Condemning memories that make you feel unclean or guilt. Isolation, withdrawal, or passive. Obsessive compulsive behaviors. Distrust of others or distrust of opposite sex. Abandonment or fear of abandonment. Fear of being alone and so involved in everything to not feel the loneliness. A fairy tale mindset or dreamer, depression, anxiety, or inability to handle stress. Now, just because you have experienced some of these things doesn't necessarily mean that you have PTSD. But as I said, in a simple form, some of the things that we were subjected to throughout our lives may have opened us up for these spirits to operate. And that being the spirit of fear, the spirit of rejection, and those other spirits that I mentioned. Fear of being alone and so involved in everything to not feel the loneliness, anxiety or inability to handle stress, shame and guilt feelings and don't know why. Self-rejection, rejection of others, putting up a wall of protection, phobias, panic disorders, insomnia. Cannot be still but always moving or doing something, or you feel guilty. You have to control your environment or you feel you're losing control. You find yourself manipulate others unintentionally or intentionally. Sometimes intimidate others to get your way or because you feel you are right. Being anxious on a daily basis. Shutting down emotionally. Eating out of stress or habit rather than hunger. Withdrawing and isolating. Stuck on grief like the death of a loved one. And as I said before, there's nothing wrong with grieving. But at some point, we have to come out of that. We come out of that grief. Amen. Self-pity. Stuck in what others have done to you. Living in the past. You see a God that does not really care or love you. Overwhelming feelings of hopelessness. Driven to help others and not take care of self. You get hurt because others don't seem to receive from you or understand your intentions. There are some sicknesses and diseases that can come through that. As the medical field has determined that heart disease can come from that, stroke, diabetes, type 1 and 2, asthma, depression, inflammation, fibromyalgia, cell damage, all the autoimmune diseases such as rheumatoid arthritis, lupus, inflammatory bowel disease, multiple sclerosis, psoriasis, Graves' disease, and others. And we know that through reading the New Testament, that Jesus healed, he rebuked a spirit of infirmity, and that caused that person to be healed. So we see through that scripture that sometimes deliverance brings healing. Deliverance brings healing. God wants to restore us and restore us to, from what the invaders and trespassers have stolen from us. He wants to restore us. Look up Joel 2:25. And I will restore to you the years that the locust hath eaten, the cankerworm and the caterpillar and the palmer worm, my great army, which I sent among you. And ye shall eat in plenty and be satisfied and praise the name of the Lord your God that hath dealt wondrously with you. And my people shall never be ashamed. Also in Jeremiah 30:17 and in 1 Peter 5:10. And Jesus wants to not only deliver us, but heal us. In Isaiah 61:1, the Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord hath anointed me to preach good tidings unto the meek. He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and the opening of the prison to them that are bound. Anybody ever felt like they was in a prison? And that they were bound up? No hope, nowhere. Gloom, doom in the room. Heaviness, depression. A prisoner to depression and heaviness. Been there, done that. But thanks be unto Jesus Christ, there was a way out. And there is a way out. Don't get to the point. Come find somebody. Call me. Don't get to the point to where it's over. I know I've been there before, but I can tell you one of the things that knowing Jesus is that happiness is if you have a clear mind. This world cannot buy you that kind of happiness. There's nothing in this life that can bring peace in your mind, that can bring you to the point to where you can love your enemies. That's happiness. Because those that can't love their enemies, that pillar knows all about it. I always say, if a pillar could speak, because we tell our pillar everything. Amen. We say everything that's on our hearts and on our minds, and some things we don't even know we said. But if that pillar could talk, happiness is having the mind of Christ. And all my life, I've come to that realization. There's so many pathways on this life that somehow look like they lead to happiness. But at the end of the road, it's a disappointment. The only happiness in this life is the peace that Jesus Christ can bring you in your mind, so that you're not walking around in paranoia. You're not walking around like the world is out to get you. You're not walking around thinking something that's not even there, thinking somebody's against you that they don't not even thinking about you. Amen. Happiness is here. Seek Jesus to bring you that happiness. The devil is a liar. Jesus said he's a thief and a liar, because he's come to steal, kill, and destroy. And what he wants to steal is your faith. He wants to steal your peace. He wants to steal your joy. He wants to steal that part of you so that you can walk around in stress, anxiety, unforgiveness, bitterness, and everything that makes you miserable. And people seek drugs and alcohol and all kinds of things like that so that their mind will leave them alone. We can't be ball and chain to our minds, because we have the power in the name of Jesus. I want to do a deliverance for you guys. For those that want to participate, I want to lead you in a prayer real quick. Father, I ask you to forgive me. Please repeat. Father, I ask you to forgive me for all anger towards you. I also acknowledge that I have sinned against you by not forgiving those who have offended me. I've been critical and judgmental towards others. I repent of this and ask your forgiveness. I also acknowledge my inability to forgive without your help and without your word and without being obedient to your word. Therefore, from my heart, I choose to forgive. Now just take a minute and insert the first person that comes to your mind. And then others after that. I bring under the blood of Jesus all that they have done wrong toward me. I release them from owing me anything. I remit their sins against me. Heavenly Father, as my Lord Jesus, ask you to forgive those who had sinned against him. I likewise pray that your forgiveness come to those who have sinned against me. I renounce all retaliation, vengeance, and bitterness. I ask that you bless them and lead them into a closer relationship with you. I renounce all rejection, rebellion, fear, torment, self-rejection, and all the pain that these spirits have brought me. I give them to you right now, Lord. Now begin to release those spirits and that pain. Just let it go in the name of Jesus. Let it go. All pain and suffering, go now in the name of Jesus. Every bit of pain and suffering caused by demonic spirits, I command you to come up and out right now by the authority of the name of Jesus Christ. Get out. Get out right now in Jesus' name. The longer you stay, the longer your torment in hell will be. In the name of Jesus, all spirits of fear, the fear of man, come out in the name of Jesus. Take a deep breath and breathe them out. If you feel like coughing, coughing. If you want to make them go by coughing. In the name of Jesus, self-pity, insecurity, and inferiority, go now in the name of Jesus. I come against all spirits of heaviness that bring depression. Come out in the name of Jesus. All mental illness, come out right now. Break the powers of mental illness. Come out in the name of Jesus. Obsessive compulsive disorders, schizophrenia, come out. Suicide, come out in the name of Jesus. And grief, come out. Come out, unbelief. Come out, double-mindedness. Come out in the name of Jesus. I come against every gatekeeper of fear. I come against the spirit of bondage right now in the name of Jesus. I come against every spirit of rebellion right now. And I break your power. The spirit of rebellion, come out in the name of Jesus. Come out. I say, come out. Double-mindedness, the cares of this world, and all things that give us a divided loyalty to Jesus Christ in our heart. All the things of this world and divided loyalties, come out. Every seed that Satan has sown into our heart and mind, I command it to go. Every seed, every thought, every planting of the devil, come out. We uproot you by the hand of God, by the finger of God, in the name of Jesus, the blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus. Bipolar disease, come out. Unbelief, compulsive behavior, addictions rooted in fear, addictions to alcohol, addictions to drugs, addictions to food, addictions to anything, addictions to fear, rejection, anxiety, come out in the name of Jesus. Self-pity and the lie that we cannot or will not be healed, I break the lie that the devil speaks into our minds and our hearts in the name of Jesus. We can be healed in the name of Jesus. We will be healed. I come against the victim spirit and the martyr spirit and any form of mental illness in the name of Jesus. Any sickness, disease, and torment, come out in the name of Jesus. I break the powers of the sicknesses, of those sicknesses I mentioned, in the name of Jesus. Come out in the name of Jesus. All those sicknesses that I mentioned, in the name of Jesus, the blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus, the blood, the blood, the blood, the blood. I break your power, your rule, and your authority. Come out, come out, come out now. In the name of Jesus, the blood is against you. You have no rule, no power, no authority. In the name of Jesus, spirits of discontent, complaining, the vagabond spirit, wandering, irresponsibility, and witchcraft. I break the powers of witchcraft. Come out. Witchcraft, come on out. In the name of Jesus, witchcraft and rebellion. Come out. In the name of Jesus, generational witchcraft. Come out. In the name of Jesus Christ. All witchcraft rituals spoken over us as kids, I break those powers right now in the name of Jesus, the blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus. Anything offered as a sacrifice for us when we were children, we break the powers of it right now. Come out. Come out in the name of Jesus. Generational lying spirits, come out. Gambling spirits, poverty spirits, laziness, addictive behaviors, greed, come out. Bitterness, the root of bitterness, come out in the name of Jesus. I break the powers of the root of bitterness, jealousy, strife, anger, gossip, hatred, profanity, slander, and murder. The spirit of murder, I break your power right now. Physical murder, mental murder, and verbal murder. I take authority over every spirit over our tongues right now in the name of Jesus that causes us to commit verbal abuse and verbal murder. Come out. Verbal murder. Abuse. Come out. Spirits of abuse. Come out right now in the name of Jesus. Come out. Break your rule, your power, and authority. You must let them go. You must let them go. Bitterness that comes from being hurt or mistreated. Right now, in the name of Jesus, all that pain, all that shame, all that guilt, come out. Injustice that has occurred towards ourselves or others in our family, and the spirit of Cain, which is a murderous spirit, come out in the name of Jesus. All thoughts of murder, all thoughts of evil, all thoughts of wickedness, come out right now in the name of Jesus. I break your power. You cannot hide. You cannot stay. You must go. You must go. You must go. Evil speaking, come out. Hard-headedness, come out in the name of Jesus. We renounce you. We denounce you in the name of Jesus. And that unforgiving spirit, I command you to go, including unforgiveness towards others, retaliation, vengeance, come out. Forgive us, Lord, for any time that we or our family members have sown seeds of discord or caused pain to us or others through their actions. Forgive us for acts of maliciousness or things that we or other family members have done with the intent to hurt and cause pain to others. Forgive us and those in our family line for selective obedience or ignoring the prompting of the Holy Spirit when you wanted us to show love, mercy, and compassion rather than judgment and condemnation. All those unforgiving spirits, we bind you up and we collect you and we tell you, you must go. And bitterness, you must go. Everybody take a deep breath and breathe them out. Breathe them out in the name. Come out in the name of Jesus. And the spirit of pride, come out. Pride, come out. I break down the root of pride. Come out in the name of Jesus. You must go. Lawlessness and rebellion, self-ambition, presumption, and testing God. Come out in the name of Jesus Christ. And heart disease, we break your power. All heart disease, stroke, diabetes, 1 and 2, asthma, depression, inflammation, all inflammation in the bodies. Come out. Fibromyalgia and cell damage. We release the power of the Holy Spirit to come and rejuvenate our cells, every cell and every fiber of our being. We come against every autoimmune disease, such as rheumatoid arthritis, lupus, inflammatory bowel disease, multiple sclerosis, psoriasis, and Graves' disease. We come against you right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Now stand to your feet. Stand to your feet in the name of Jesus. Please stand to your feet. And we break your power right now in the name of Jesus, the blood of Jesus. Forgive us for believing these lying spirits when they tried to form false image in us. Your word says that we are fearfully and wonderfully made, and we are made in your image. We are accepted just as we are. Lord, forgive us and our family line for despising godly wisdom and authority or rejecting your counsel. Forgive us for self-rule and choosing authority figures that did not represent your government or authority for our lives. We repent from any time that we have cursed God or others. Forgive us, Lord, for loving gossip, slander, and our judgments more than we love your law of showing love and kindness. Forgive us for not blessing others more freely, even those we do not like or those that have been an enemy. We renounce these things right now. We forsake them in the name of Jesus. And we break and come against all soul ties right now. Soul ties in the spirit realm, soul ties in the physical realm. We cut every soul tie right now to generational line spirits in the name of Jesus. We cut them right now. We cut every umbilical cord. We cut every garland right now. We cut every ley line in the spirit realm attached to us, attached to our homes, attached to anything that we own. Illegitimate spiritual fathers or spiritual leaders, religious attitudes, spirits of legalism, disrespect, self-righteousness, prejudice, controlling behaviors, manipulating, imposing our will on others, racism, disobedience, independence, critical spirits, arrogance, vain, and judgmental attitudes. Lord, we give them all to you. We give them all to you right now in the name of Jesus, and we command them out of our bodies. Come out. Come out. In Jesus' name. In Jesus Christ's name. Now I'm going to loose loose over you spirits right now. I'm going to loose good spirits over you right now. Loose good spirits. We loose the fire of God right now. We loose the Spirit of God and the baptism of the Holy Spirit. If you don't have the baptism of the Holy Spirit, just lift your hands and take a deep breath. If you had it and you haven't used it in a while, ask God to restore it and just let it go right now. We loose abundance of life in every area. We loose adoption over you rather than rejection. We loose the angels of the Lord, blessings, a contrite spirit, counsel, might, knowledge, and the fear of the Lord. We loose full deliverance and healing right now, a spirit of excellence over you. We loose a spirit of faith and faithfulness. We loose the fervent spirit of the Lord over you and fervent fire of the Holy Ghost. We loose the fervent fire of the Holy Ghost inside of you right now to burn out all spirits that are hiding in the name of Jesus. We loose the freedom in Jesus Christ and the goodness of God. We release you to serve the Lord in fullness and without condemnation. For therefore, there is therefore no condemnation in those who are in Christ Jesus. We loose grace and mercy, honor, humility, the joy of the Lord, life more abundant, the love of Jesus, meekness and quietness, ministering angels, newness of life, patience, peace, and all the fruit of the Spirit, power, love, and a sound mind over you, the spirit of praise, the spirit of prayer, the quickening power of the Holy Spirit. We release it right now over you, a retentive mind and healing in the mind. We loose a right mind over you in the name of Jesus. We loose a strong mind and a sound mind over you. Lord, heal us in our minds, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Heal us in our entire bodies. Heal us in our emotions, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Heal our broken and wounded spirits, O God, in the name of Jesus. We loose spiritual riches and the seven spirits of God. We loose spiritual strength, spirit of truth, spirit of understanding, a gift of, and fruit of the Spirit, and the spirit of wisdom. Just receive it. Just start praising the Lord in the name of Jesus. Just praise him with your prayer language in Jesus' name.